Joey Dawejko is a very talented heavyweight all the way from Philly. Today he put on a show over here. All jokes aside, man, you got the moves a little bit like Adrian. I like the defense, the shoulder roll.
Yeah, man. A lot of people don't know. I knew all these guys growing up, man.
Like who?
They're the amateurs. I knew Adrian. Danny Garcia is actually one of my best friends.
What do you think about his success? Danny Garcia shocking the world every week.
I'm so proud of him. Like, he don't even know, but...
Sorry.
See you, ladies. Hey, we just brought up the rating of this video by like 90%. Gerald, like, my video was okay, but now... So, Danny Garcia, you're from Philly.
Yeah.
Are you the only heavyweight right now, or Brian Jennings?
Yeah, Brian Jennings.
And what's it like for you when you go places? Do people know you're a boxer right away?
Or
they think?
Not really. I mean, I had a big amateur career, but that's long gone.
You guys remind me of the Gabe Rosado's trainer. What's his name?
Yeah, Billy Briscoe. That's actually my cut, man.
Is that the deal with? Have you seen Billy Briscoe with the beard?
Yeah, man.
You guys know Gerald Washington, the heavyweight?
Yeah, how you doing, man?
I was actually supposed to fight him.
What happened?
Times, man.
Didn't work out.
No, I guess not.
How was it?
Dominic, too.
Yeah.
Dominic Brazil, talented kid.
Yep.
I like them tonight. You should put on a show. What do you think?
Man, he got some skills, man. I noticed that when we found out we were going to fight, man, I was watching your tape and stuff, man. I noticed his skills right away. You guys are definitely good boxers, man.
My favorite fighter is James Stone.
James Stone, you remind me of him a little bit, the way you were moving, the body, too.
I love James Stone.
James got skills. So, what was it like to grow up in an amateur with Adrian Broner, Danny Garcia? Who else was there at that time?
Oh man, everybody that's making it right now, pretty much. I know them. I had 68 amateur fights. I won 14 national titles.
You're kidding?
Yeah, I won the world championships in 2007, the under-19 world championships in 2007. The youngest ever to win the Eastern Olympic Trials. I was 16 years old. So I mean, I had a great amateur career. I knew all these guys, man. They're all champions now.
What's your record right now?
8-3-2 now.
You know what? You're just starting.
This is like my seventh undefeated fighter that I fought in my professional career. I take fights, man. I'm not.
Well, put
a
it
bum.
Like this.
I'm not a bum. I like fighting. You know what I mean?
What do you say about that? You gotta give him props because he goes to other people's backyard. He's here in LA. We're not nowhere near Philly. And he's taking on tough guys that are...
Thing, man. He was catching Charles with some nice left hooks, man.
Charles is a good fighter,
You're
man.
Fighting knockout artists.
Yeah. That's the first time I was ever stopped. It's going to be the last time I was ever stopped, but...
Well, no, listen. Hello. After Magomed, everybody's so much more careful because nobody wants to...
You know what? I got offered to fight Magomed and... On a day's notice, they offered me $20,000.
One day's
notice.
Wow. And what happened?
I said, I'll take it, no problem. And they called me back and said, listen, we got somebody else. Don't worry about it. They said, we'll send you some money just for saying that you'll take the fight. And I was like, all right, whatever. I never got it, but.
Oh, that's messed up. But right now, Michael went world praying for it. We hope he pulls through.
Yeah, man.
God bless him.
I'm definitely sad about that. Man.
So tell me about the amateurs. What was Adrian Broner's personality? Because everybody told me he had the same
exact way he is now. Him and his little brother Andre.
The twin? They look the same.
Yeah.
How do you tell the difference?
I could always tell the difference.
Broner's a
little. Yo, listen, man. I knew him since he was this big. From Cincinnati.
Still
in the silver gloves, yeah. Right. And the silver gloves, running around with his gold tooth, shooting dice, man. I'm telling you.
He has a very, very tough fight come December 14th. This is the toughest fight of his career, toughest fight of Marcos Maidana's career.
Yeah.
How do you see the fight unfolding?
Adrian's a great boxer, man. He's a great boxer. Maidana's really tough. I think Adrian will pull it out though.